Naaman said unto the Israelites, and the God of heaven, he will prosper us. Therefore, we his servants will arise and build. 2 years ago, when the Lord asked us to build, no one knew how this could happen. Our reaction was nothing different than what Noah did.
Early on,
it
could be very costly. Instead of punting from deep in their own territory, we're already at the midfield right now.
Yeah, and that's just that quick throw. And again, it's not a three-step drop. You just.
Dad, what are you doing? I'm watching this.
Genesis 6:14. Gen 6:14.
Joan, do we have a Bible anywhere?
Genesis 6:14. Make thee an ark of gopher wood. Gopher wood.
Gopher wood. Get it?
Go.
Well, it's not really gopher wood. I just like the wordplay.
No, it was pine and maple that was clear cut from this valley to make room for all those houses.
Excuse me, do I know you?
Not as well as I'd like. I see you got my housewarming gift.
That was you? You sent those? What are they for? Hey!
Genesis chapter 6, verse 14. I want you to build an ark.
You want me to build an ark?
Yes.
So that's why the tools, and you are responsible for the wood?
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, let's just start over. Ha! Hello, I am Evan Baxter.
Baxter, born June 15th, 1962, 8 pounds, 11 ounces. Mother's Carol Ann Parker, father Eugene Evan Baxter.
Ooh, you have internet access, very impressive. Do you also have cable?
You're a clean freak. You care much too much about your outward appearance. Your left nipple is a quarter inch higher than your right nipple, and when you were a little boy, you were afraid of Gumby.
Who are you?
I'm God.
You're God?
Yes. And I want you, Evan Baxter, to build an ark.
Okay, you know what? This conversation is a little thing I like to call over. But I gotta get going, because, frankly, I have an ark to build. Busy. Nice meeting you. Take care. Oh, and... all right. See you later.
On the 23rd of April, 2006, Pastor Tunde Badru and his wife commenced the mission to build, starting with just a few committed workers, in a place called The Beginning.
How can I ever forget the first day we moved in here? It's been over 7 years now, approaching the 8th year. With a few of us, God used us to get the work going. And now God has taken us from one level to a higher level, and we have more to do for the Lord. What a great God we serve. He's taken us from a very small building like this to a magnificent one that is given to us now.
Set to fly on eagle's wing, the church grew in faith, rising above several challenges ranging from tight government regulations to financial hurdles. Yet, another miracle emerged.
Scripture says that the glory of this latter house shall be greater than that of the former. Starting from a very small building over there, to a magnificent one right here, just in the space of 3 years. God indeed is a faithful God. The challenge in that building was $40,000 to make the parking lot. We were only six people, but God surprised us and provided $40,000 when we didn't even have $400 in the account. At this building, the challenge moved from $40,000 to $150,000. Within a space of 1 week, when we didn't even have $1,500 in the account, yet God showed up. What a mighty God we serve.
That miracle was the beginning of a greater miracle to come. just like the Bible says in Nehemiah 2:20, the God of heaven prospered us, and in less than 3 years, the Lord lifted us to see and be part of a greater glory. Like you said in Haggai 2:29, the glory of the latter house shall be greater than the former.
With God, nothing shall be impossible, says Luke 1:37. It was $40,000, $150,000, $700,000 to close on the loan. And yet, the Lord had moved, almost completing a new sanctuary for himself. Just a few things left to be done.
Don't give up yet. We are yet to reach the finish line. Just as David charged Solomon, now, my son, the Lord be with you and prosper you in building the house of the Lord. We grant unto you wisdom and understanding. Only be strong and of good courage. I charge you today, be strong and of good courage. There's so much to do. You may ask, what else do we need to do to move in? There are four categories of needs. Starting with 750 seats in theater sitting style in the category 1. Each seat costing about $150 each, we're requiring total of $112,500 to get theater seats on the ground floor to create a conducive atmosphere of worship. Also in the category 2 is the state-of-the-art media equipment, audio, visual, and lighting equipment, requiring about $265,000 to match and provide the atmosphere of worship that's required. In the third category is children, church, and classroom furniture, office furniture, and equipment furniture, our church interior and altar decoration, all together with children playground in the third category. In the fourth category, you have paving extras and steel extras. Totally about $1.2 million total fund to move in. Amen. Donation can come from you, either as an individual or family. Sponsorship can come from a category or groups. Time frame is very short. Arise now and let us build.
We want to bless the name of the Lord for King's Palace, Katy. And the last time I was here, it was just grass. And to see between this short period of time, what you guys have been able to do for this mighty structure being here, you know, the soccer field moved backward, plan for the basketball, tennis courts. It's an amazing job. But one thing I know is that no man can do anything except God be with him. So I really, really, really want to congratulate your pastor, Fatotunde Badru, and my brother, and all the members of this church for an excellent, excellent job. As you are working for the Almighty God, as you are charging forward, pressing forward, building for the Almighty God, God is going to build your home.
Amen.
He's going to build your family.
Amen.
He's going to build your finances.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. And as you are building, one thing that I know about our God, God is no man's debtor. As you are sowing into God's kingdom, as you are sowing into building God's house, God indirectly, we see to read that it sows into your life, it sows into your family, it sows into your business. But one thing I'm always afraid of is that our God, once he starts something, he completes it. God doesn't do any project halfway. He's not a God of incomplete project. So I really want to encourage us, we members of this church, that what we have started, we must continue. Let us spend and be spent for the kingdom. If we have to borrow money, if you have to sell our houses, sell our cars, if you have to get equity from our houses to build this thing, our God is a God that doesn't forget. He remembers, he sees what you are sowing. And one thing I know, nobody ever sows into God's kingdom and ever regret it. I've been following God for over 40 years. Every investment that I've given to God's kingdom in building God's house, I've received over 100% return. So please, I want to employ us, I want to charge us, I want to encourage us. Please let us rise. Let us build this kingdom. Let us build this house. Let us build this tabernacle. And the God of Abraham, the God of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, the God of Adeboye, we see to it that you receive a hundredfold return in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I will be here in April.
Amen.
We are going to open this.
Amen.
And I can promise from my own side, help will come from North America.
Amen.
Help
Amen.
Will come from Nigeria.
Amen.
And help will come from my family.
Amen.
But I want you to do your own part too, so that when heaven is reckoning, you will see my name, James Fadile, here. You will see Redeemed Christian Church of God, North America. You will see RCCG worldwide. Please, I want you. This is our house. We are going to build it.
Amen.
And God is going to applaud our effort. The angels in heaven are going to bless you. And heaven will see to it that you are rewarded a hundredfold in Jesus' name.
Amen.
God bless you.
Amen.
It is well with you all in Jesus'
name. Amen.
Let's come together, brethren. If God provided $40,000 with a few people, like six, $150,000 with less than 50 people, and then $700,000 with few more people, he surely can provide 1 million, 1.2 million, 2 million, 5 million to build. We need just only about a million to complete all that we have to do. I'm sure God will find you faithful and find you a useful vessel. God bless you as you join us to build and complete the sanctuary for the Lord. Amen.
No more pain, I will rise.